The forest of Sarawak is one of the oldest in the world. There are a lot of animals, there are a lot of insects, there are a lot of flowers and faunas that are found in this part of the world, which cannot be found in other parts. And besides that, Sarawak is one of the most diverse in culture. You know? The indigenous people of Sarawak, there are about 36 different indigenous groups in Sarawak. So what is happening now, the government is proposing to build some dams, big dam. They will flood thousands and thousands of acres of land, and it will submerge the forest, it will submerge the villages, and all these beautiful things that we have in Sarawak. And of course, it will displace the indigenous people to places which may be very, very foreign to them. My name is Peter Kalang. I'm the chairman of Safe Rivers. Safe Rivers is a network of all the people who are going to be affected by the proposed dams that the government are trying to build. We are trying to protect environment and defend the right of the indigenous people.
Saya Michael Jolosat. Saya bekerja kenyah, Ulu Baram. Saya punya umur 66 tahun.
Ake Ulau Ngau. Umur ke 67.
Saya Tike Tangan Ani dari Lungutin Patah Baram.
Kami orang mau batas dam.
Right now, I'm standing at the site of the proposed Baram Dam. The government is planning to build this dam to provide energy to the so-called industries.
Ake nyat lesau ngan telu anak ayan buliang tida mena.
The government of Sarawak is building another 12 dams after they build the second largest dam in the world, which is the Bakun Dam. So the first of the 12 dams is Murum Dam, which is now nearing completion. The Bakun Dam cover an area of 71,000 square, what do you call hectares, the size of the island of Singapore. And then the Baram Dam, which is the next one after Murum, is going to be half that size. So if all the dams that the government is going to build will be built, thousands and thousands of acres of land having forests, and the most biodiverse part of the planet Earth is going to be destroyed. But beside that, on the social aspect of it,
if this Baram Dam is to be built, it will flood an area of 412 square kilometers. And this will flood more than 26 longhouses along the Baram and its tributaries. It will displace more than 20,000 people, the Kayans, the Kenyas, and the Penans.
Nah, kami pindah, kalau dia kami pindah kami, orang lain lagi, kami pindah ke sana, orang pun tidak mau terima kami. Sebab ini hak dia orang. Memang kami bertanggung jawab dengan hak kami. Dia orang pun tidak mau terima kami.
These people will be relocated to a resettlement area. Once they are relocated from the original place where they live, it will affect definitely the culture and the way of life. If such relocation is going to be done, it may spell the end of this ethnic group.
Kami ini sutuk betul-betul bah. Lagi kerjaan buat kami sutuk lagi.
Kami tidak dapat memakai tanah untuk kami ditanam telaman, untuk kami buat tembasan, untuk kami cari makan, tidak kami padai pakai tanah 3 ika saja.
Most of these people are subsistence farmers. They need to live on a piece of land where they can plant whatever they need. Cash doesn't mean so much to them. Now, if they want rice, they plant rice. If they want tapioca, they plant tapioca. All these things are produced on their own land. So once the dam come and they are displaced into a resettlement area, they will not be able to do that, because from our past experience, when these people are displaced, they are given 3 acres of land. 3 acres, it is not for one person, but one household. Yeah? One household means, in the context in Sarawak, it could mean more than one family. This dam will do a lot of environmental destruction, but it also affect the social life of Sarawakian and affect the indigenous people very badly.
Nama saya Yakub Jalung, orang kampung sini Tanjung Tepalit, asli sinilah. Inilah kerja kami orang kampung, nak bikin rumah, kayu kami dapat sendiri dari hutan, kami potong sendiri di hutan, angkut sendiri di hutan, sebab kami tak ada duit nak beli kayu. Jadi inilah kebanggaan kami mempunyai tanah yang cukup luas, daerah yang cukup luas tempat kami cari makan, cari kehidupan.
Saya berada di tapak perkuburan Kampung Losalatong di Kan dan Lepuk Gak Tanjung Tepalit. Di sini saya berdiri di atas kubur datuk saya, dan ini adalah kubur nenek saya. Yang di sini adalah nenek saya, termasuk adik saya, dan termasuk anti saya di sini. Ya, ada 4 orang di sini. Kenapa saya sayang ke tempat ini? Kenapa saya takut ini akan tenggelam 200 kaki dari sini? Saya sayangkan tanah ini. Kenapa mereka telah membuat tapak ini, dan mereka memang asal dari Baram, memang tidak mau. Saya percaya pun kalau dia masih hidup, dia tidak mau Baram Dam ini akan terjadi. Itu saja. Bagi tahu Taib Mahmud, kami orang tidak mau Baram Dam. Saya percaya orang sini pun, yang datuk saya sini pun, memang tidak mau Baram Dam ini terjadi. Saya percaya Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, ganti tolong kami orang sini.
Ada saya dengar perancangan kerajaan nak bina dam, tapi saya tetap binakan rumah ini sebab saya masih mau tinggal di kampung ini, di tanah, di kawasan ini, di sungai kami ini.
IHA is a short form for International Hydropower Association. The members of IHA are big dam builders from all over the world, big suppliers for equipment used in the dam, and of course the big financiers who finance the construction of the dam. So most of the people who are at the Congress are people who support the idea of mega dams. And during the Congress, on behalf of the Safe Rivers, I had the chance to intervene.
To improve, I welcome and we welcome highly.
Mr. Kalang, I'm the chairman of Safe Rivers. The majority of people who are affected by the dams do not agree with the dam. And even today, there are more than 300 people outside this hall who are against the dam. They cannot join this conference. Yeah? Even I myself was not allowed to join that workshop on Monday. I was told to get off. I'm very disappointed, and that is the reason. Tomorrow, on the 23rd of May, we are going to have an alternative conference at the Riverside Majestic. All the delegates here and the journalists are invited to come and listen to the other side of the story. What Tonston and our state secretary are saying is not the full story. During the IHA Congress in Sarawak, is trying to greenwash the dams that are going to build, that abuse human rights. We therefore demand that the Sarawak Energy, the Sarawak government, stop all the construction of the dams in Sarawak.
Sarawak. Let all native customary rights be respected
in observance of the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of the Indigenous Peoples, UNDRIP, in all projects carried out in the state, the voice of the people must be respected. Let the government resolve all outstanding problems from Batang Ai, Bakun, Bengoh and Murum dams immediately in a transparent and meaningful manner. Let the International Hydropower Association suspend Sarawak Energy's membership in IHA and that Mr. Tonstein Dale Shotwit be removed from the board of IHA until Sarawak State Government and SEB clean up the mistake it made in the past. IHA should stop promoting Sarawak dams as best practice until these demands are satisfied.
I think your voice has been heard to some extent. I can't get you the exact words of what the State Secretary has just said this morning, but he made some profound statements about the next dams.
But I've been very unhappy with what has been going on.
There's a legacy of problems here.
Yeah. And so we want the Congress to listen and respect the voice of the people here. There's so many people here to protest against this megadam project in Sarawak. We don't want our land, we don't want our home to be destroyed by this megadam project.
I will take this message into the Congress. I'm supposed to be speaking now in front of another 500 people.
So but you don't need to listen to us here.
We've heard. I want everyone to be safe.
Our message is no megadam. Do not build megadam anymore in Sarawak. That is our message today. To save our people is no megadam project.
I hope you go
in and tell the people that there is no more megadam in Sarawak, okay? That is what we want to hear from you.
We are not only taking
you must safety. Assure that. You must assure us that no more megadam project in Sarawak.
I can't assure you that.
That is what ISA 04. Promote megadam. Which destroy indigenous people.
Destroy your land, destroy forest.
If you understand, there is no answer for that. Okay. Go in and tell people.
Please, sir, remain calm. Otherwise, you'll just get yourself into a situation where you...
We are not only thinking of the safety now. We also think tomorrow and the future. Because once the dam are built, there is no safety.
Well,
okay.
This is why we want you to listen.
Respect our rights and no more megadam in Sarawak. Stop all megadam in Sarawak.
Our people's safety is more important than our safety.
We want to protect our forest. We want to protect our land. Save our people. Save our people. Save our people. No more megadam. This is our message. Tell all the people inside there.
It's heard. Okay. Your message is heard. Yeah. You also need to talk.
We have written to the Prime Minister, we have written to the SEB, written to so many authorities, but
they just neglect the voice of the people.
Do not imagine. Can you mediate on that, sir? Sorry?
Can you mediate on that? State government and our people.
We will try. You have my sincere promise that we will try.
Yeah. You assured us today.
We will follow up with you.
We have been trying. We send memorandum petition.
If you shout at me, I can't
answer you. Yes, you said we have to follow the proper channel as you said just now. We have been doing that.
Can you meet that?
We want to sit and talk with the state government. We are here.
But I will do my best to communicate the message that you've delivered here into that room.
We sincerely hope our message will be heard and respect it.
I'll do my best.
And we don't want any more megadam now.
besides the demonstrations that we had, we also had a big conference of our own. We call it the Alternative Conference. And we invited speakers who have experience in fighting against the dam.
You have a good campaign, and you have a generous heart, and you have a love of your land. Over the river, at the IHA conference, are rich and powerful people from elsewhere who do not know your land, who do not love it, and do not care about it. I went to the Sarawak Museum yesterday and saw that Sarawak Energy wants to, and I'll quote, "The preservation of Sarawak's cultural heritage is at the heart of Sarawak Energy's social responsibility." It is a lie. At the heart of Sarawak Energy's doings is lust for money and power and disregard for culture. The weapon they do not have, which you have, is love of country. Your love of country against their greed for money and power. You have inspired us to be with you on this journey until there is no Baram Dam.
Selalu orang cuma boleh bila bercerita tentang pembangunan, isu yang selalu dibincangkan adalah berkenaan dengan kos pembangunan, nuts and bolts, berapa konkrit, berapa batu, berapa besi. Tetapi biasanya dalam pembangunan-pembangunan ini, nilai alam sekitar itu tidak masuk. Derang tidak kira berapa harga kita punya kayu-kayu, kita punya budaya yang akan hilang semuanya. Semua ini tidak masuk dalam kos pembinaan. Kami nampak dua kabel besar atas tu, ya, dari Bakun pergi Bintulu. Tapi satu titik tenaga pun tidak masuk pergi kampung. Semua pergi mana? Untuk memenuhi keperluan industri-industri yang mengotorkan negeri Sarawak ini.
Apabila kerajaan tidak menghormati, tidak mengiktiraf kita punya pemakai menua, sedangkan undang-undang, sedangkan mahkamah menghormatinya, maka apabila kita tahu hal ini terjadi, maka sepatutnya lah kita akan mendirikan satu kerajaan yang baru yang menghormati adat kita. Ini yang penting. Nak cakap kalau, tapi kita tidak dibenarkan cakap kalau if anymore. Stop the dam, itu saja. Stop the dam. INT dam.
The indigenous people of Sarawak live in upper reach of the river. In the interior, some are living on the mountains of Sarawak, where the environment is beautiful. And these people, of course, they want development, but development they need is what we may call as people-centered development, centered on their values, centered on the life that they cherish. Of course they want roads, of course they want water, of course they want electricity, but it has to be centered around them. They do not want industries which will destroy the environment. They do not want industries which will destroy their own land and their lifestyle. So development, yes, but destruction, no. It must be a development which is people friendly. And we are inviting people from all over the world, from Europe, Africa, and all parts of Asia, the Americas. We campaign this in Sarawak, but we really require a lot of support from international bodies, international people, so that our campaign is even more effective. You can visit us on our website, which is savesarawakrivers.com. Try to spread this word around. Put it on the social media, like Facebook or Twitter, so that more people will come and support this cause. So you can help us to preserve the environment and at the same time to preserve a culture which is unique, found only in Sarawak.
Sarawak!